Hello everyone, let us continue with the vector operations that we started in the last lecture. So the first vector operation that we saw was multiplication of a vector by a scalar, right? And we took an example of, let us say we got vector p and we are multiplying with a scalar s, then in that case we will get a vector over here. Okay, so remember this: when you multiply a scalar with a vector, you will get a vector. Now, magnitude of q will be equal to magnitude of p times s, or you can say s times p. Okay, and direction of q will be same as direction of p. So these are the key points that you need to remember. Let us talk about the another vector operation that we discussed, and that was addition or subtraction of vectors. Okay, now in this we said that we can only add or subtract vectors which are of same type. So we can add, subtract vectors of same type. So I cannot add a vector like velocity with force. Okay, both are vectors, but I cannot add. But what I can do is, if I have some force F1 and another force F2, I can find out the resultant force, which will be, let us say, F of 3. Okay, so F3 will be F1 plus F2. Now in this addition and subtraction of vectors, there are few cases. Let us talk about them. So first case is, let us say the vectors are parallel to each other, okay, and they are pointing in same direction. So if you have one vector like this and another vector like this, okay, so if this is vector AB, let us say the magnitude is 5 unit or 5 centimeter, then you got vector BC which is having unit 7 centimeter. Then in that case, what we can do is, since they are pointing in same direction, they will be added and unka resultant will be what? Vector AC. Okay, since we have added AB and BC, what we'll get is AC, and the total magnitude will be 12 centimeter. Now this is possible, linear addition is possible only because they are parallel. Now what if they are anti-parallel? Now when I say anti-parallel means what? You have vector A pointing in one direction, vector AB. Let us say this is 10 centimeter, and you have another vector which is vector BC. Okay, now this is pointing in the other direction. They are parallel, but they are pointing in opposite direction. That is what anti-parallel means. Okay, let us say the value or the magnitude of BC is 5. Then in that case, the resultant vector will be AC, and the value will be, magnitude will be 5 centimeter, and direction will be along AB, definitely because AB is having a higher magnitude. Alright, now these are the cases when you have things in parallel. Now what will happen if things are not in parallel? Means you have vectors which are intersecting at some or the other point if extended, right? So let us discuss those cases and how to solve, how to find resultant over here. So there are two things that we can do. First thing over here, for vectors which are not parallel or anti-parallel, what we do is we can use triangle law of addition. So let us talk about this triangle law of vector addition in detail. And there are few properties that we can prove by using this triangle law. So let us say you got one vector A over here, and there is this another vector somewhere over here which is B. So they are neither parallel nor anti-parallel. So what we need to do is, we need to form a triangle by using these two sides. Now one way of doing this is, you put vector A over here. Now shift this line such that, shift this vector B such that it starts from where there is this arrowhead of vector A, right? So let me draw this in series actually, not series, parallel with the vector that we have. So this will look somewhat like this. Okay, so what I have done was, previously whatever was the vector over here, I shifted it over here so that it aligns with the vector A. Now the resultant of this vector A plus vector V will be found by drawing a vector which will join the starting point, which is over here. Let us say this is P, this is Q, and this is R. Then by joining this point PR, what we get is, we get the resultant vector over here. So my resultant vector R, which is addition of vector A plus B, can be found out by using this method. Okay, we can also write it as PR vector, which is the resultant, this is equal to PQ vector plus QR vector, based on the names of the arrow. Right, so these are vector A, vector B. Don't forget to put arrow or bar on the vector names. Right, so this is how we can use triangle law of vector addition. Now we can also show a few properties over here. The first property is called as commutative property. Now to understand this commutative property, what we can do is, we can redraw this. Okay, this is one version of finding completing the triangle. Let us talk about another version of completing the triangle. We will keep B as it is, and this time what we will be doing is, we will be moving A so that it starts from where the arrow of B ends. Okay, so where the arrow of B is there, we'll start A from there. Okay, so right now what we have done is, we have shifted this vector A above to come in line over here. Okay, so we can do that. Now again, by using this triangle law, we can find the resultant by drawing this arrow or vector which starts from the starting point of vector B and ends at the ending point of vector A. Okay, so again over here what we have is resultant, which is equal to vector B plus vector A. Okay, now from this equation number 1 and equation number 2, what we can write? We can write vector A plus vector B is nothing but equal to vector B plus vector A. And this particular equation or expression is nothing but commutative property. Hope you all understood this. Now we can prove one more property over here, and that property is called as associative property. So in associative property, what we will do is, we will have one more vector over here. So with this A and B, we can have one more vector, let us say. Okay, so let us say we got vector A like this, vector B like this, and then we have vector C over here. So this is A bar, B bar, and C bar. And let us say this is the resultant vector that we have over here, which is denoted by R. Okay, now what we can do is, we can complete two triangles over here. One is over here. Okay, so what will this vector be? So right now we need to concentrate on this triangle. Okay, so this vector will be nothing but vector A plus vector B. Vector A plus vector B. Now let us talk about this side, this diagonal. So in this diagonal, what we can say is, this diagonal is nothing but, this is starting from vector B, right? So it is vector B plus vector C, because it is ending with vector C. Okay, so how to find out these vectors, kiska resultant hai? Look where it is starting and where it is ending. Okay, so this the leading diagonal is starting with vector A and ending with vector B, therefore we name it as vector A plus B, and dusre wale ka this way. Okay, so I hope you all understood this. We'll continue this in the next part of in the next video.